Hello and welcome to Learn Statistics class. In this class we are going to learn the statistical concept in simple and more easy way. The topic of today's lecture is mathematical expectation. In this topic we are going to learn determination of mean and variance by probability generating function and the examples on probability generating function. So let us start with determination of mean and variance by probability generating function. In this point we shall learn how to obtain mean and variance from the PGF of a discrete random variable x. We know that by definition PGF is defined as PXS, which is equal to expected value of S raised to x is equal to summation S raised to xi into probability i is from 1 to n. If we expand this summation, we get this is S raised to x1 p1 plus S raised to x2 p2, like that S raised to xn pn. This is the expansion of probability generating function of a random variable x. Let me call it as equation number 1 for our further references. Now I will differentiate equation 1 with respect to x. Differentiate equation 1 with respect to s, then we get d by ds of pxs derivative, which is denoted by p dash xs, is equal to x1 s raised to x1 minus 1 p1 plus x2 s raised to x2 minus 1 p2 plus up to xn s raised to xn minus 1 pn. This is the derivative of equation number 1. Then call this equation as equation number 2. Further differentiate equation 2 with respect to s, means we are going to differentiate equation 2 once again. Then it is d2 by ds square pxs, which is equal to p double dash xs, and this is equal to x1 into, we will differentiate s raised to x1, x1 into x1 minus 1 s raised to x1 minus 1. This is a simple derivative. Student, know how to differentiate x raised to n. If we differentiate x raised to n, then we get its derivative as n into x raised to n minus 1. Further, we differentiate it, then we get n n minus 1 x raised to n minus 2. Like that only. Simple differentiation. Plus dot 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 up to xn minus 1 s raised to xn minus 2 into pn. This is equation number 3. Now in the next step I will substitute s equal to 1 in equation 2 and 3. Then we will see what will happen. So, put s equal to 1. In equation 2, we get let us look here. This is the equation 2. If we put s equal to 1, then we get x1 1 raised to x1 minus 1 p1 plus x2 into 1 raised to x2 minus 1 p2, like that xn into 1 raised to xn minus 1 pn. But 1 raised to something is always 1. So the expression comes is x1 p1 plus x2 p2, like that up to xn pn. So let me write it. Px dash s equal to 1, then it is x1 p1 x2 p2 plus up to xn pn, which is equal to summation xi into pi. I is from 1 to n, and we know that this is nothing but the expected value of x, which is the mean of random variable x. Therefore, mean equal to probability of PGF at the point s equal to 1. This is the formula for mean from the PGF. In the previous lecture, we have already learned how to obtain mean in the mathematical expectation. But in this lecture, we are going to learn, we are going to obtain mean and variance not by using the mathematical expectation, but by using the probability generating function. So mean equal to px dash 1. Now we will put s equal to 1 in equation 3. We get, this is equation number 3. In this equation, if we put s equal to 1, what will happen? Let us see the first term. It will be x1 minus 1, 1 raised to x1 minus 1, p1. Similarly, x2 minus 1, 1 raised to x2 minus 1, p2. Like that, xn, xn minus 1, 1 raised to xn minus 1, pn. And since 1 raised to anything is 1, we get, therefore, after putting s equal to 1 in equation number 3, we get x1, x1 minus 1, p1 plus x2, x2 minus 1, pn plus up to xn, xn minus 1, pn. I will write the expression p double dash x s equal to 1. It is x1, x1 minus 1, p1 plus x2, x2 minus 1, p2 up to dot 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 plus xn, xn minus 1, pn, which is equal to, if we write it in the form of summation, then it will be summation xi xi minus 1 pi. I is from 1 to n, and we know that this is nothing but, by the definition of mathematical expectation, expected value of x, x minus 1, and after simplifying it, we get p double dash x1 is equal to expectation of x x minus 1, which is expectation x square minus x, and this is nothing but expectation of x square minus expectation x. We know that the expected value of x is p dash x 1. Therefore, the expectation of x square is equal to p double dash x 1 plus p dash x 1. By definition of variance, variance of x is given by variance x equal to expectation of x square minus expected value of x bracket square. By putting the values of expected x square and expectation x, we get variance x equal to px double dash 1 plus p dash x 1 minus p dash x 1 bracket square. Since we have already calculated the values of expectation x and expectation x square with the help of PGF, this is the variance in terms of probability generating function. Now we shall see the examples of calculating mean and variance by using PGF. In the previous lecture, we have already learned how to obtain mean and variance by using mathematical expectation. If a student want to learn that lecture, then click on the I button at the top right corner of the screen, and link of that lecture is also given in the description box. So let us start with examples of probability generating function. Example number 1, the PGF of a random variable x is 0.5 plus 0.3s plus 0.2s square. Find the mean and variance of x. Here we have already given the probability generating function, and we have to calculate the value of mean and variance with the help of PGF. In this lecture, at the starting of the lecture, we have already learned how to obtain mean and variance. We will use that formula to obtain the mean and variance of random variable x. I will write PXS is equal to 0.5 plus 0.3S plus 0.2S square. Differentiate this equation 1 with respect to s. We get p dash x 1 p dash x s is equal to 0.5 is constant, so it is 0. Plus 0.3 into 1, since derivative of s is 1, plus 0.2 into derivative of s square is 2s. So it is 0.3 plus 0.4s. This is equation 2. Further differentiate equation 2 with respect to s. We get we get double dash x s is equal to, since this 0.3 is constant, it is 0 plus 0.4 into 1, so it is 0.4. then we use the formula of mean and variance. Let me put the value of s equal to 1 in derivative of PGF. We get, this is the, call this equation as 3. By putting s equal to 1 in equation number 2 and 3, we get Px dash s equal to 1 is equal to 0.3 plus 0.4 into s. So it is 0.3 plus 0.4, which is equal to 0.7. And by putting s equal to 1 in equation number 3, we get equation 3 is P double dash x s equal to 0.4. So after putting s equal to 1, it is 0.4 only, since there is no s in equation number 3. Hence mean equal to P x dash 1, which is equal to 0.7. This is the value of mean by using probability generating function. And variance equal to, variance x is equal to P double dash x 1 plus P dash x 1 minus P dash x 1 bracket square, which is equal to 0.4 plus 0.7 minus 0.7 bracket square, which is equal to 1.1 minus 0.49, and that comes to be 0.61. This is the value of variance of a random variable x by using probability generating function of x. In this way, in this lecture, we learn what is probability generating function and how we obtain mean and variance by using probability generating function. Further, we learn how to calculate mean and variance with the help of an example. If student want to learn the other concepts of mathematical expectation, then click on the I button at the top right corner of the screen, and link of that playlist is also given in the description box. In the Learn Statistics channel, many more concepts, topics from the statistics are already discussed in the previous days. The link of all the playlists are given in the description box. Student can refer that playlist by pressing at the I button at top right corner of the screen and from the description box also. If student like this lecture, then please click on like button, share with your friends, and subscribe to Learn Statistics channel in order to learn the statistical concept in simple and more easy way. We will meet in the next lecture with the next concept. Till then, we will stop here. Thank you.